Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, we're gonna paint the second part of this seascape painting here, the lower end here, the part of the sea. These are the colors that we're gonna use. It's the palette that I mix for the second layer. Some blues, some greenish tones. And the first thing is we establish the line on the horizon with a bit of a darker color. Bluish, darkish, greenish color, and a bit softening down the edges, of course. And then we start to build up those different colors that we have here. See, we have this darkish bluish color, then lighter one, this bit more purplish, darker color. Here we build up the darker wave details. The more foreground, and we start, of course, to build up the reflections from the sunlight we have, and a bit more foreground we have the kind of a white water. You see, I build it up very random. I'm using the brush to in all kinds of directions to get in this random shape here. You know, I'm building up the mid-wave center detail with a darker color, and then I show you the whole build up of the white water of the splashing wave in time lapse. It's easier this way, and you see I'm also already again using the color of the background, kind of shining through in some places. And this color is not a pure white that I apply here. As you can see, we still have room to add some more lighter tones. Don't forget to add the reflection of this whitish color here. And again, I'm adding already here now a ton of detail. These were fine water reflections. And I put in a glaze for the right part of the wave. And of course, everywhere, millions of dots and details, lighter colors, darker colors. And really make sure that you do it in a very random way. You know, we build up the wave part on the right side, a small wave here that we have, connecting the parts. Again with a glaze on this bigger wave here. And you see I'm constantly adjusting the color, getting a bit more blue in now on the left side. It's a very thin color. As I said, it's a glaze. Again using the color that we put on before. It looks flat and off. And the magic key here is to add these reflections here. Basically the sunlight hits, and yeah, we're adjusting the middle ground here with some lighter bluish tones. Another secret to a good seascape painting, you need and want to have color variations. You know, mixing the color for the wave in the foreground. And start to build it up similar to the wave in the middle ground. It's a bit more of a greenish, bit more brownish tone. Constantly mixing while I'm going, and yeah, adding here now the parts where the water is very thin. Doesn't make any sense up to here now, but you will see a bit later that this will really start to look realistic when you build up this. It's basically this water that has a lot of sunlight going through. And we have lots of contrast here, very dark colors, front part. Here I'm adding the white water part doesn't look really white, but it's part of the wave that's in the shadow, more or less. And I build up on top of this, right, the foam parts, the splashing water parts, the lighter parts here. I see very fine brush, very random marks, still following the line of the wave. Getting even tinier, as you can see. And these are the details that you need and want to put in to really get this reflective character in. You know, I'm building up the splashing part of the wave in the more shadowy area, over the already or still wet color here. See, just brushing it in, this grayish color here. Adding some details, some darker colors, lighter ones. Yeah, we're a bit more down the road now with this painting here. And you see, we have a ton of reflections. And yeah, due to the nature of this day, very sunlit day, and the water being very reflective, we need to put those little marks in. It's very time consuming, but it's vital, I think, when you want to give this character, when you want to show this character of this very bright day on the water surface. Therefore, we need to put in all kinds of random marks, different sizes, different shapes. I'm basically working all over the place, as you can see now, establishing now the wave on the right side. And some more detail parts here and there. These dark marks basically mark the area where the water will be put on later on. And I'm building up the water part with a bit of a dry brush glazing technique here. Adding some color to it. It's a very dry color, actually. Leaving the space for the white water that we add on top of it. And again, we still don't use a pure white color in this case here. And we are using a bit of a trimmed down white so that we can add later on some very crisp highlights on this foam part, on this splashing water here. And they really need to stand out. Yeah, here, for example, they really need to stand out and make this thing, much more crisp. And it's something that you need to really take care about, to not go too light on the foam part of the water. Same goes on the left side for the foam part. I did already add some more detail. And you see those very fine white marks here, they really add to this watery character sort of thing. Yeah, going back and forth, adding here some more details, some more reflections. Now we add the reflection on the front part. On the beach, more or less. Some lighter, darker tones. Adding the final details, like the shadow beneath this white water here. Some more crisp highlights. Here and there. Yeah, and we finished. So if you like this topic here, make sure you check out one of these two other videos here.